Welcome to the very first Trader Joe's haul of 2022. I'm sorry that it's a couple days late. I usually go to Trader Joe's on Thursdays, and that's the day that I upload the video as well too. But we had a snowstorm here, so we could not get out of our house for 2 days. So it's Saturday, and we were finally able to get out. Everything's starting to melt. The taste test video will be tomorrow on Sunday because we have got a lot of new items to try that I am super excited to dig into. So let's get started. First, we just picked up this organic French baguette. We're gonna be doing some barbecue chicken sandwiches, and then we're gonna cut this up, and this is the bread that we're gonna use to fill that barbecue chicken with. It's gonna be really good. And then these are some of just our weekly staples. Sourdough bread, gotta have it, we love it. I've been craving some broccoli. I like to throw this in the air fryer, so we just grabbed some organic broccoli right there. We got two russet potatoes. I'm gonna be doing some cheesy potatoes in the oven. We got some organic cherry tomatoes, one orange. We're gonna be doing an Asian stir fry dish. We're gonna be doing some orange glazed meatballs. So I need a big orange for the sauce for that. And then we just got some hand soap. I love this scent. Botanical Bounty one. This one's so good. This is a foaming one as well too. So we picked that up. And then we got some cilantro over here, as well as some spinach, the organic baby spinach, one of my favorites, some jalapenos, and then some staples, the gluten-free noodles. I buy this almost every time we go, the penne pasta, as well as the rotini one. Both of those ones are really good. And then we needed to stock back up on some of this garlic naan. We keep this in the freezer, and this is just perfect. You toast it in the oven. It comes with four pieces in here. It's just nice to have for an easy lunch. You can put whatever you want on top of that, or you can dip this into hummus. And then we got some of the teeny tiny avocados. And then I did pick up a lunch for me today. So I chose this. This is the classic Greek salad. It's with feta cheese, Kalamata olives, red wine vinaigrette. And it's got all that stuff in there. It looks like there's onions and some red peppers. Looks really good. I haven't had this salad before. So we picked that up. And then like I said, we're gonna be doing like an Asian stir fry this week for dinner. And I did have like on the list, like all these vegetables by themselves. And I came across this kit, and it was so much cheaper just to buy it like this. So this is the Asian style vegetable stir fry kit, and it comes with everything that I wanted to get in here. It looks like there's snap peas in here, some broccoli, some baby corn, mushroom, carrots, everything that you can want. So that was a really good deal to find it just already together like this. So I picked that up. And then we're also gonna be doing some pizzas this week for dinner. This is one of our favorite crusts at Trader Joe's. It comes with two of them in here. They're really big. We also like the frozen one, the organic pizza crust as well too, but we picked this one up this time. And then you've gotta have the seasoned pizza cheese to go with it. This is just a staple with homemade pizzas. You've gotta have it. This just makes it that much better. So we picked that up, and then as well as just some regular organic shredded mozzarella cheese. And then we've got our first new item. So this one is the sesame teriyaki beef skirt steak. It looks really good. This will be in the taste test video. Here are the nutrition facts on there, and then the ingredients. So of course it does contain soy, sesame, and wheat. But yeah, we're really excited to give this one a try. We'll probably make some rice and put this over it. And then we needed some cream cheese, so we picked some of that up. And then we've got some new items over here. So first up, we've got the mini chocolate chip pancake and waffle mix. And it says that you just have to add water, so really excited about this one. I wish it was gluten-free, it's not. I do make Tristan his own gluten-free chocolate chip pancakes for him, so we keep those in the freezer. I make like a big batch of them in the beginning of the month. So excited to see these. Lakeland will love these ones. And then let's turn it around over here. Those are the nutrition facts and the ingredients on those. So this one, of course, will be in the taste test video, as well as this next item, the Kalua Pork Spring Rolls. It's a Hawaiian-inspired spring roll with smoke-flavored pork and vegetables. That sounds really good. It comes with four of those in there. And here are the instructions. You can put them in the air fryer, which is what we will be doing. I like it when they have the air fryer instructions on there. And then here are the nutrition facts. So two pieces, 290 calories. And the ingredients are right there. And we've got another item over here. This was brand new last year. We did pick it up last year, and I absolutely loved this macaroni and cheese. And for some reason, they only had it that one time, so I never got to have it again. So I did buy two boxes this time because it was so good. This is the French onion macaroni and cheese. It's with Swiss and cheddar cheese, croutons, and roasted onions. It's in the frozen section. Get it. It is so good. I absolutely loved it. So yeah, excited that Trader Joe's finally came back out with this one. And then we've got another new item that will be in the taste test video, and that is the pizza bread cheese. It's a mild cow milk cheese seasoned and baked golden brown. It's gluten-free. This is a cheese that like doesn't melt. So you wanna like grill it. You gotta heat it and serve. You can either put it in the microwave, it says, or you can saute it, which I'm gonna probably saute this up for the taste test video, but look at that. Excited to try that one. And then we've got yogurt over here. One of them is my go-to. That's the organic plain yogurt, the grass-fed one. But there is a brand new yogurt that came out, which I'm also equally excited about because this one's non-dairy. My son can have this one. This one is the organic creamy cashew yogurt, and it's plain, unsweetened. He likes this brand. They have like the little yogurts of this one. He likes the vanilla one. I'm gonna try sweetening it for him and see if he likes it, but it is dairy-free, which is awesome. You can make like yogurt parfaits with this, sweeten it up however you like, fruit, honey, all that good stuff. And then let's turn it around. Those are the nutrition facts. So it does have 0 grams of added sugar. That's one benefit of the unsweetened one. And then those are the ingredients. So it contains cashews and coconut. So yeah, really excited to have this. They need to come out with this one, but the vanilla one as well too, like have both options. Cause I know my son really likes the vanilla flavored one. We'll see if I can sweeten it up for him so he can like it. And then we've got our last new item that we are gonna try in the taste test, and that is the organic cacio e pepe puffs. So they're cheese and pepper, corn and rice snacks. I'm not sure how I feel about these ones. These ones are gluten-free, but I'm not the biggest fan of the pasta sauce. So I don't know how I'm gonna like these ones, but we will try them and let you guys know in the taste test video. And then we've got some condiments over here. This one is becoming my new favorite hot sauce. This is the habanero hot sauce. It is very hot. But you guys know me, I like my hot sauce. So we needed to pick up another one of those, as well as the Sofrida Italian style seasoning blend. This stuff is really good as well too. I added on anything like Italian. So on my pasta sauce, pizza sauce is another great one. You can even put it on chicken in the crock pot with some cream cheese and stuff. Really good stuff right here. And then this one is Brent's favorite taco sauce that Trader Joe's carries. This one is the organic spicy taco sauce. It kind of tastes like the Taco Bell hot sauce. So that one's his go-to. And then Tristan wanted some cookies. So these ones are great. They're completely allergy friendly. They are the soft bake snickerdoodle cookies. So yeah, that is everything that we got in this week's Trader Joe's haul. Stay tuned, like I said, for tomorrow for the taste test video. I will see you guys then. Bye.